Hey, Spark fans, Rob Reynolds here. In one of my previous lives, I worked in an industry that had bursts of fast-paced craziness, where people would come up to me and ask me for the moon and expect me to hang it for them too. And their ask was always the same. I need this, and it's gotta be great, it's gotta be fast, and it's gotta be cheap. And my response was always the same. Pick two. All right, so flash forward to my current life. And you know how I like to make things move through sufficiently advanced technology, creating the illusion of what Arthur C. Clarke would call magic. Now, you would think if I wanted a motor for a project that was highly efficient, very smooth, and high torque, well, by my own rule, I would have to pick two. But that's not always the case. With a good brushless motor, you can have all three of those things. And what's really cool about them is by adding some sensors, not only can you control them in the usual way, but by spinning the motor, you can control other things, having the sensors read the position of the motor. And we wanted to give you all a chance to start working with brushless motors by giving you everything you need on a single board. The motor driver, the sensors, and ESP32 as the brains. We put it all together and we're calling it the new SparkFun IoT Brushless Motor Driver. On this board, you'll find at its heart an ESP32 microcontroller, that versatile IoT stalwart with its dual-core processor, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth capabilities, and its wide range of GPIO pins, many of which are broken out on this board. To drive the motor, there's a TMC6300 from ADI Trinamic, an easy-to-use three-phase motor driver with up to 2 amps of total drive current. Separate high-side and low-side control of the three half-bridges allows for incredible control of each phase of the motor commutation. We found the Arduino Simple Field-Oriented Control Library to work well with the TMC6300. However, an FOC algorithm requires some feedback to close and optimize the control loop. They require more complex software and hardware implementations. Therefore, we integrated a TMAG5273 Hall Effect sensor and three INA240A1 current sensor amplifiers, along with an MCP6021 operational amplifier, into the board's design. This allows users to incorporate position sensing and current sensing into the FOC algorithm or any feedback control loop they implement. What that means is that you'll be able to get feedback letting you know exactly where the motor is positioned at any time. The board also has a WS2812 RGB LED for user feedback, a boot button, reset button, and a pair of user programmable buttons, a quick connector, a 3-pin JST connector to the gimbal motor, and of course, a 3-phase brushless DC gimbal motor itself. One of the beauties of this board is that not only can you use it to control a motor, but thanks to the sensors and software, I can also spin this motor to control other things. These sensors can read its position and use it as a smart knob. In fact, Scott Bezek created an amazing smart knob with this, the same sensor, the TMC6300, the Hall Effect sensor. It's so good that I'm not even going to try and do anything for you. I'm going to suggest you go take a look at his. He's got video of it up on YouTube, and he's got the entire thing open source on his GitHub repo. Thanks, Scott. You're awesome. Now, what I will do is, since this is the IoT brushless motor driver, I will demo the IoT part of that. Now, for me, if I see IoT in something, generally it means that I should be able to control it from across the room or across the world, or receive feedback from it. So that's what I'm going to do with this. I made a quick phone app, and I can connect it to my motor driver. Great. And from way over here, pretend I'm on the other side of the world, I can change the speed of my motor. Oh, look at that. Oh, I can even, wait a minute, reverse it. Okay, I didn't ease into the reverse, so you saw a little bit of jerkiness there. But if I was doing this for real, I would certainly have a little ease in. We can make it go forward. We can add more speed to it. And again, I could, with a little more programming, and actually our first example has this kind of programming in it, I could be receiving feedback of the position of the motor while it's spinning. It's very cool. Now, I do want to stress that this really is a board designed for prototyping. Now, if you're making a smart knob with it, this motor is perfect. It's really smooth, perfect size. It's going to give you great feedback. However, if you want to use this to drive something, this motor is not really a high torque motor, so you're not going to be able to open and close your blinds with it, or pan your telescope across the night sky to Star Trek, or even run your funicular up and down in your Italian Alp model train set. You're going to need to go with a bigger motor for any of those applications, but you'll already have everything programmed and prototyped and ready to go, thanks to the new SparkFun IoT brushless motor driver. Let's face it, you need this board. You need this board. Come on, you know you need the board. Wait, does this help? You need this board. Stay safe. be kind, and happy hacking. Hey, Spark fans, Rob Reynolds here. Dang it.
Control algorithm requires some feed.
Pick two.
Back to close and optimize the control loop.
Where people would come up to me and say, actually, that wasn't bad.